And now, a word from our sponsors.
Can't beat the morning rush? Need to get somewhere and get there fast? Need to get there safely? Fare no more with the free burn. Life's a dream with this time-saving machine.
Good morning to you all, and welcome to today's show. The time is 9:03 according to the studio clock, so I shall get to reporting today's news. Men who served in the peace efforts in Europe after World War II returned home and were reunited with their families.
Men actually returned from the Vietnam War and were reunited with their families.
I'm sorry. It appears that we've crossed signals with a false news reporter.
Apologies, listeners. We've picked up someone else's broadcast, and they're either living in the past, or stupid, or both.
I am deeply sorry to those listening this morning for this slight technical error. We're trying.
Yeah, what she said. We're going to have to cut to a song.
Song, yes, and we'll be right back after this. It wasn't Russians trying to take over our signal, was it?
Those things would kill you, you know.
You're the only one who says that. Now back to what that was about.
It was probably just some teens playing a false news show on our transmission. I very much doubt it's Russians.
Well, you can make sure that it
Look,
doesn't...
you don't call the shots. That's my job. Now get ready to finish your damn news segment.
I'm so sorry, Sarah. I think there might be radio pirates hijacking our transmission.
Really, Carl? Radio pirates? They're kind of a thing of the past.
I don't know, then a practical joke, maybe?
World War II? No war in Vietnam? I know we're ahead of our time, but that lady was just ridiculous.
Well, she's gone now, so let's just ignore what happened and get back to the north.
I suppose. But as my mum would always say, a road less travelled by won't always make a difference. Welcome back, and sorry for the technical issues earlier. Next up in the news, we have an important article about smoking, published by the Western Journal of Medicine. It essentially covers what's been going around lately, that smoking is the leading cause of lung cancer.
I am shocked. First you try to hijack my program, and then you report false information.
No, you're interrupting my transmission. And what if I said there's been false?
The smoking, my dear. There's no solid evidence that it causes cancer.
I suppose you're a smoker, then. Maybe if you put down the ciggies for a change, you'd actually notice a difference.
Well, as I always say, dear, a road not travelled won't always make a difference. Now pick up a cigarette and take a break.
We'll be right back after these messages.
Is everything all right?
Who was the broadcaster in 1950? Why did she leave?
Well, I believe there was a reporter my father fired for arguing with a hijacker live on air. Linda was her name, I think.
I think that's my mum.
I thought your mother passed away years ago from lung cancer?
She did. She was a heavy smoker, especially after the doctor told her it would help her lose weight after she had me. She didn't know any better. No one did.
So, what now?
Maybe I could convince her to stop smoking, and she could still be with us. She could come to work here, and she could live with me, and she could-
Wait. Even if that is your mum, are you sure that's a good idea? Isn't messing with time meant to be bad?
This isn't some sci-fi show about blue police boxes.
I know, but just think about it.
Well, what do I do then?
Finish the show early and go home. I think you need rest.
Did you hear me? You're done.
I don't really know what I've done.
Arguing with strangers alive on air. I don't know what goes through a woman's mind, but that was just idiotic.
Surely you can't be serious.
I am. Now pack your things and leave.
Once again, we are back.
Wait.
However,
they're back.
Issues, I have
Let's see what they have to say.
But before I leave, I want to leave you all with this. You're standing at a crossroads. Both roads will take you to the same place, but as you start to walk down one path, you wonder if the other may have been a better option. Would you go back if you could, even if you've reached your destination? Or could it be that the road less traveled by doesn't always make a difference? My name is Sarah, and this is me signing off for today.